Hey, what's going on, everybody? Dave back again, and today is Saturday, I believe, October 18th. And as you saw in the beginning, I want to thank EK Hobbies for sending this over to me, actually rushing this over to me. I believe that they're going to have a few on site over there. So definitely go check them out. There will be a link down in the description, and also their website at the beginning of the video. So I'm really excited for this. I've been picking these up. I do blame Rick, the reviewer king, for this, for getting me started into these. Basically, I don't know, focusing my collection. Like, majority of what I have is all Terminator and now Gangster, and that's pretty much what I'm sticking to. And like his views and his videos is, you know, it really makes you think, create your own story in your head, because this isn't from a movie character. It isn't, there isn't anything to nitpick, or really nitpick and, you know, compare, oh, you know, Scarlett has 14 freckles on her right cheek and the Hot Toys only has 12. This is, you know, that kind of stuff. So what we've got here is the GKS 001 from Gangster's Kingdom, and this is the Saxon, which was available at the China Toy Show. I'm really happy to have been able to get this, and I think you guys will want to stay tuned to my channel over the next week, because the video layout plan is as they get delivered. I have Dread coming, which I believe will be here on Monday. I have the J exclusive from the Singapore show. That should be here on Tuesday. Wednesday, I believe, I will have Spade, what is it, 4? They're not in order, it's just how they're ending up showing up. I have Spade 4 coming on Wednesday, Spade 3 coming on Thursday, and then probably tomorrow I'll try and put up, I've had him Diamond 2 for a couple weeks, and I'll try and put him up for tomorrow. So the only one I'm missing is Spade 2, the Vinnie Jones, and I do really want that, though I'm not willing to spend the $400 plus that people are wanting. But if you have one, and you're wanting to trade it off, I am willing to trade off one, possibly two of my Terminator, or my DX13, something like that. I'm looking more to trade any of my Terminator stuff if you guys are interested, so hit me up. All right, so again, I went over this with the Diamond 3. I really like the individual boxing, how they're sealed, so no one else has tampered with them. So this is just the standard brown box. We'll get that out of the way. Now, I've already pulled off the cellophane off of here, but I haven't gone through him because I want you guys to see him as I end up seeing him. On the front, you do have this kind of snake pattern on here. It is all smooth, though, except for where the lettering is. You know, you've got, because he's not affiliated with a gang, you've just got a circle. I kind of consider these, though it's a side story, I kind of consider these the Jokers of the set. I don't know how many of that they're planning on doing on the side story, but that's the way I kind of view them in my head. You know, you've got all the different suits, and something like this would end up being the Joker, you know, the wild card of the series. So we'll just kind of go around. I do like with the exclusives, they do have in the gold foil, the serial numbers on there, GKS 001, meaning Gangster's Kingdom side story 001. Flip it around. I believe that's Mike Magnolia, I believe, is the artist that did the Hellboy series. I have some of his artwork and stuff. This is very reminiscent of his stuff. Again, you've got the metal foil or gold foil exhibition dam toys. Again, the serial number down here. We'll flip it around. Now, because I've already seen Rick's videos, I already know this is just like the Diamond 3, where it had the double-sided, and it didn't startle me coming off and thought I broke it immediately. You do have the prison backdrop, and I'm trying to see. It's kind of odd that they printed it. This is the way the cover is, but you need to flip it over to get that. So I'm going to pop that back there. Again, I do like these. These are a little tall for my display, so I'm unable to use them, but they are great for doing doing your photos and stuff like that. And you've got your front story. Over at Sideshow Freaks, there is a full thread that actually has all the stories in line, so that you can, you know, keep track of them. I don't know if that will be big enough or clear enough for you to read, but it's The Prisoner. The hope was promised with sweet taste, but life cannot escape the bitter ending. So, with this, now there is no card with this guy because he is a side story. So you get the nice thick cardboard backing that's going to come off. We'll just put that right there. Now, I really do like how they package these with the foam as compared to the Hot Toys. Now, I do understand that the reason Hot Toys does it, it's manufacturing. You know, it's easier to set up where it's stamping and you can just snap them in and everything. But I feel that doing the foam, one, protects it better, and two, you know, really brings up the quality of the packaging. You do get a comic in here. It's only about 8 pages or so. And what I'll actually do is at the end, I'm going to snap pictures of the pages. That way, at the end of the video, you guys can read the comic if you want. So I'm going to set that over there. And I do hope that they continue doing the comics, because that would actually be really cool. And I'm hoping everything is still in focus because I cannot tell. But in the first foam layer, you've got the figure itself. And second foam layer, you've got the 3 extra hands. You've got the ankle cuffs, and you've got the handcuffs. Now, I am going to pull these out. They are really nice. They are metal, which is actually a really, really cool feature. They do kind of latch in there. I'd almost be afraid of them locking and not being able to get them off the figure. So I'm going to cut this real quick. I'm going to pull him out. I'm going to pull the plastic off his hands, his head, and everything, and get all this stuff out, and we'll take a closer look. All right, so here we are. We're going to take a look at the figure himself. Now, I just have him in a basic pose. I actually have the hands on that I'm probably going to use for a while. I am going to make, one of the ways I'm going to customize him, though, is I'm going to make a 1/6 scale pack of like Marlboro Reds to go in his pocket, and then I'm going to have this one hand, which is actually a gun holding hand, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat it up a little bit, kind of close down this finger where he's holding a lit cigarette. I just think, you know, that's really cool. I was almost thinking about swapping out the heads on this with the Spade 3 with one of the heads, the normal head on it. Because I don't know, that face just looks like it should be in prison. So you've got the numbers on the front here, and they're all the same. Now, I do believe that Rick had it right with the 2014 being 2014, 10 being October, 01 being the release date. And I believe that's when, about when the China Toy Fair was. So that actually makes a lot of sense with it being that way. His shirt is kind of bunched up underneath because I popped off the head and I actually took the plastic sleeve off of the neck. And I do have him partially unzipped. Just casual, you know. You're in prison. They're not always all, you know, zipped up and everything. Only time I've ever seen that is you see him alongside the road cleaning up garbage and stuff. Now, the ankles are fairly tight. I know a couple people complained that they were really loose. It's not real bad. I'm going to later on, not today, but I'll show you guys an easy trick on how to make those ball joints tighter and where they grip better. And it's a trick that I use with my model kits to get the joints that maybe are loose. The clothing seems to be very well made. I only had to snip. There were a couple of strings hanging out of the sleeve over here. Just had to snip those. Easy peasy on that. The cotton shirt is very heavy. And the sleeves are nice and tight. I don't see them coming loose anytime soon. You can pose it with it up or down, covering up the wrist joints. He does have two tattoos. You've got an hourglass over on this one. And I had it memorized. Beginning and end is tattooed on this arm. And courage and luck with a revolver with four bullets is on that side. So we'll put it up in one of my favorite poses. I don't know why, I just love that. Now, the paint application on these are actually really well done. You've got some rosiness on the knuckles, like, you know, maybe he's gotten into a scuffle recently, you know, and it's that way on all of them. You get, you know, like I said, you get the trigger finger hand. You get it's a relaxed but closed hand, so he can actually hold something, like a broken mop handle, something like that. And you get that on both right and left hand sides. They are just a little bit different shapes, so it's not exactly the same. On each one of the hands, you do get a cross on the index finger, and it looks like a queen if you actually look at it. I'm going to experiment here, guys. I am really sorry if this does not work out. I don't know if it's going to, but on the middle finger, it looks like, if you play chess, then you'll know the pieces, and it looks like a queen. So that actually adds something to the story, at least for me, in my head. You know, that's actually an interesting thing. Maybe he had something with one of the queens of the suits, you know, which we haven't seen anything with yet. I'm hoping to shortly. I'd like to see a couple females come to this line. The head, I believe it's Ed Harris. Very, it's a great detail on there. And I'll go over everything in closer detail when I do the breakdown of it. The eyes, again, like the Diamond 3, appear to be separate. So they're inset. It gives it a good dimension in there. The color and everything is excellent. The weathering on the outfit is fantastic. The hair, if you look, it's a little bit darker back here. And then you've got some fading up here, like you can, like an older gentleman would be. You know, you can kind of see the skin through the thinning hair up there. You've got a little more gray white over here on the sides. You've got the grayish eyebrows going on. You've got the stubble. You've just got a really hardened, hardened face in there. Hey, he's seen a lot of crap in his day. On the back, you don't have anything. You do have working pockets. And the outfit is kind of tight through the waist section. There is an elastic, appears to be an elastic band through the waist just to keep it kind of snugged up. You do get the work boots. No individual laces. It is all sculpted. But very nicely done. They look like what you'd find probably a standard prison issue work boots. Nice weathering on the tips, you know, on the tips there. They've seen some miles. Now, one of the nitpicks I will have, and I know Rick said that on his lettering was kind of flaking loose on a couple. I don't have that issue, but what I do have is the weathering that they have on here, I believe was kind of a like a wash that they did on there. Some is on the zipper tab, and then some is actually on the lettering. And I don't know if I'm going to leave that on there or if I'm going to just maybe hit that with a little alcohol on a Q-tip and just dab that off. You do have some fake snaps on here. You can see the metal tabs on there. All in all, I think it's a great piece. If you're into the series and you're collecting them, I would definitely pick this up for the collection. Again, in my mind, I picture it that he's kind of the Joker of one of the Jokers of the suit of cards, which I'm assuming that they're going to end up doing, which means there's going to be 52 of them, which is going to be crazy. Again, you know, I'm really happy with it. I want to thank EK Hobbies for sending this out to me to review for you guys. And I really want to appreciate you guys for sticking around and, you know, watching my reviews and the support that you guys have shown. I am doing my best to try and upgrade everything, make things a little bit better for you, a little bit clearer. And so thanks for sticking around. And I think what I'm going to do next is I'm just going to break him down. I'm going to do some shots, slideshow at the end, and do the comic book for you guys. So you guys can read that, and then I'll do a slideshow of the breakdown of everything that comes with him. I haven't put the cuffs on him. One of the things I will say, though, because these are metal, you will want to be cautious with the tattoos that are on the wrist that they don't scrape them. So I don't know if you want to pull down the sleeves or if you just want to make sure that the cuffs stay down at the wrist part and don't work their way up because they will scrape off the tattoos that are on the arms. Nothing to worry about with the leg cuffs, though. I don't think I showed these earlier, but you get the leg cuffs. I've seen a lot of great people are doing great modifications on here. I think someone did like a prison scene. I want to do that. I want to see about making a model setup or a diorama setup for each one of the figures, at least until there gets to be too many. And his is going to be a prison cell. I already have it in my head, and that's, you know, so stay tuned for that. Have no clue when I'm going to get to that, but it will be coming. Tomorrow I'm going to try and do Diamond 2 review for you guys, get that actually up. And just go from there, you know. I will talk to you all later. Thanks for sticking around and watching. And as usual, peace out.